First, it was Senator Chuck Schumer of New York State calling the Tea Party extremists. Well, now it's Massachusetts Congressman Barney Frank throwing more punches at the GOP.
As with Congresswoman Bachman and some others, we are talking about people who sometimes inhabit cloud cuckoo land. And in cloud cuckoo land, that could be the case.
So why is the mainstream media staying mum on these Democrats and their mudslinging? Brembo Zell is the president of the Media Research Center, and he joins us from the Washington, D.C. area. Good morning to you, sir.
Good morning, Steve.
You're a conservative. What's the weather like today in cloud cuckoo land?
Anytime the Republicans enter into any kind of debate, immediately you hear the media go into this discussion about civility, how we need to be civil in our tone. It's always the case. But let Barney Frank do what he's doing. Let Chuck Schumer admit in a conversation that he didn't realize that the press were listening to, let him admit that what he is saying and calling them extremists is a planned statement that the Democratic National Committee are talking points that they are doing, wink, wink, nod, nod.
Right.
Let them undertake those kind of personal attacks, and it mums the word from the same press to call for civility. What hypocrisy.
Well, as you always say, turn it around to say, what if a Republican did it? I mean, what if there was a conference call with Eric Cantor, say, and he didn't realize that there were reporters listening in on the line, and he called the opposite party extremist? You got to figure that would lead all the newscasts on all the other channels for about a week and a half. Great big type in the New York Times. And yet none of the shows really touched that on the mainstream media, right?
Not just that he called them extremists, but he was calling them extremists and then pause and say, that's what I was told to call them. That's what we're all being told to call them. Now, in other words, I don't believe it. I'm just being told to do this. These are my marching orders. Look, we know the Democrats have had this extraordinary discipline going back to Clinton years in 91 on talking points. Mm-hmm. It's to be respected, even admired, when they are being honorable and honest.
Sure.
But when they go into the realm of dishonesty and personal attacks, it's the same discipline that they're exercising. Now, that may be what they do, but the press, I don't care about them. What I care about is the hypocrisy of the news media that are always lecturing Republicans on civility, but are absolutely silent when, by the way, no man is more responsible for the housing collapse than Barney Frank himself when this man takes the gun personal attacks.
I know. Let me ask you this. I'm going to run a little soundbite from a Democrat congressman from the great state of Washington, Jim McDermott. He has a crazy statement. And I want to get your comment on how many major news operations are going to be talking about this today. Let's listen.
I'm tired of reading the Constitution and all the silly things we've done for the last 13 weeks.
That was yesterday. How many, there you got a member of Congress talking about that silly Constitution, and who needs to read that silly Constitution? If he were a Republican, you got to figure what?
Well, if you were a Republican saying that, the media would be, I think, shocked. The fact of the matter remains, most in today's newsroom, Steve, I think they agree with him. I think they believe that the Constitution is a silly, outdated piece of paper. And can't we get on to more enlightened things than this silly thing called the Constitution? I believe many in the news media agree with this radical. And by the way, let's start calling them radicals and extremists in their own right. These people are extremists. And it's not a personal attack. That's a reality. This is an extreme position when you attack the Constitution that way.
Well, if you don't pay attention and listen to the Constitution for guidance, then what is telling you what to do?
Our whole system of government is based on the Constitution.
Yeah.
Without the Constitution, what you have is a democracy that falls apart. This government can't exist, can't survive without the Constitution. Men like McDermott want to throw it away because it's kind of silly. Those silly founding fathers.
Oh, those pesky laws. All right, Brent Bozell, joining us from the Washington
area
today.
That might be cuckoo.
Cuckoo land, that's right.
Take care.
Thank you, sir.